Hi everyone, my name is Dave Watkins and I'm a graphic designer, I'm an illustrator, and I'm a YouTuber. Today I'm going to demonstrate a number of techniques using Adobe Illustrator plugins from Astute Graphics. More specifically, I'm going to talk to you about offsetting paths using the AG offset tool. The standard offset function in Adobe Illustrator is a great tool and I've used it myself for many, many years. That being said, it can get quite tedious and quite time-consuming when you have to execute multiple offsets within a project. Whether you're working for yourself or whether you're working for a client, being able to save time is priceless. So let's not waste any more time here. Let's go jump into Illustrator, where I'm going to demonstrate a number of techniques that will help streamline your workflow and help save you time. So let's go get started. Okay, here we are in Adobe Illustrator, and we're looking at a crest that I created for this demonstration today. Now, I'm not going to break down the entire creation of this graphic right from scratch, as that would take a while. What I am going to do is show you all the instances where I used the AG offset tool and how that sped up my workflow versus my traditional techniques that I would have used before I discovered the AG offset tool. So let's turn this off and take a look at the base path that creates the pen tool. And here what I used to do if I wanted to create multiple offsets was to select the path and go object path offset path. I would then pick a value, in this case negative half an inch, and hit OK. I would then repeat that however many times I felt I needed copies for. I go object path offset path, OK, object path offset path. Okay, and that can get quite tedious and quite time consuming, especially now if you changed your mind about how big you wanted that offset to be. So in this case, if I wanted to reduce that space, I'd have to delete all of these paths that I created and I'd have to start again. I have to go object, path, offset path. And I found myself doing this all the time where I would change my mind and have to adjust. And it meant undoing work and starting again. But what I'm going to show you now is the AG offset tool. So right now I've got the offset tool docked up here. If it's not docked for you, you can find it Window, Astute Graphics, AG offset. And once it's open, you can select a path and then apply an AG offset to that path. And now you can pick the number of steps that you'd like to offset to. So let's go down to 5, and you can now change the distance of all of those offsets at once, either by using the up or down arrows or by defining a measurement in here. So this gives you all kinds of ability to quickly preview what multiple offsets at different distances look like. And this is just gonna save you so much time. Let's reduce the steps down, maybe 4, and increase the distance, space them out. And that is just on its own fantastic time saver. But there's even more that you can do with the offset tool. Okay, so the crest is coming along nicely. I'm going to show you another technique with the AG offset tool that will save you a bunch of time in your workflow. So let's go over here and pick up this path, and we're going to apply an AG offset to it. By default, the offset paths are going to retain the original characteristics of the path, so the original stroke weight and stroke color. But we can change that over here. There's this option that says retain. We can come down to force, and we can force the stroke color to be something different if you wanted your offset paths to be a different color. And you can force the offset path stroke weight to be smaller or heavier as you see fit. So we can create an effect that looks like this. Let's tighten up the spacing and maybe add one more step. So all that is really neat. It saves some time versus having to create those and alter them manually with the traditional offset path function. But here's the real time saver. We've created this effect, and say we want to mimic that on several other paths within our document. These squares here traditionally what I could do is pick up all of the offsets that were created, and I could hold down Option to create a copy, and I can try to align this perfectly and drop a copy over there, and I can do that same thing up here. And that works in some instances where you're trying to mimic paths that are the same shape and size and positioned in such a way that you can accomplish that. But you may not be so lucky if you're trying to apply this effect to a circle, for instance. You would just have to keep notes about how far you offset things, what your stroke weights were, and you'd have to be going up and down to the menu over and over again, going object, path, offset, path, to mimic this effect up here. With the AG offset tool, this function is applied as a layer style, and it's live. So you can actually copy this and drop it up here onto a path that's completely different. So let's access that by opening up the appearance panel with our path selected. You can see that the AG offset effect is here. You can turn it on or off with the visibility icon. But the neat part here is if you pick up this appearance by clicking on the thumbnail, and you can drag it out now to multiple paths within the document, applying the same effect with just this one click and drag. And it, to me, was a really cool way to save time mimicking this effect throughout the document. Okay, the crest is coming along nicely. We're getting towards the end of it. But I've got another way to use the AG offset tool that I want to share with you. Two ways, actually. So let's take a look at this. Down here at the bottom of this crest, I've got an open path. Up until this point in time, everything that I've applied the AG offset to has been a closed path. An open path like this traditionally would have been kind of annoying to deal with, because this is what's going to happen if you use the normal offset function. If you go object, path, offset path on an open path, no matter what distance you have in here, whether it's a negative or a positive, the path is going to be offset in both directions. And there are some instances where that would be helpful and you can use that to your advantage. But you see what's happened here is you end up with a closed path that has been offset from this open path. And more often than not, for me, when I was trying to do this, I wanted either a negative or positive offset. I didn't want both. So I'd either have to use the direct selection tool, press A on the keyboard to pull that up, and pick up elements of the path and delete them manually like this. And it would take several extra steps to get to a point where the effect was what I was going for. With the AG offset tool, you can avoid all of that hassle because it will apply an offset to an open path like this, and you can choose a negative or positive distance, and it will apply it just like so, and you don't have to go through all those extra steps of deleting the unwanted offset that was created with the traditional offset function. So this is cool. Let's put this back in place. And that makes me really happy not having to use the scissor tool or the direct selection tool to streamline that path. Now, there's another feature here, another way that it's going to save you time, and it's similar to the ability to change your offset without needing to delete paths and start again. When I started this crest, I thought that this bottom section here would be squared off, but then I changed my mind and I wanted to add some rounded corners to this path. Again, traditionally, if I had offset this, I'd be stuck with multiple paths and I'd have to delete the ones that I wanted to change, and then I'd have to start from scratch. So here we're going to go back to the direct selection tool, and we're going to pick up the two points on the bottom, holding shift to select a second point. And now, using the traditional rounding widgets that are in here, the rounding handles, I'm going to apply radius to these corners. And because this effect is a live effect, the offset that you created with the AG offset tool is going to update automatically based on how you round these corners. So that can be very handy, very time-saving, because you're not having to go back in and recreate new offsets if you change your mind about the composition of a path. One final note here, because it is a live effect, if you are in outline mode, you can't actually see these shapes until you expand them. So you can achieve that by having your path selected and going Object, Expand Appearance. Or if you're in the AG Offset panel, you can detach all selected offsets, and it has now created the traditional path that you would see in outline mode. But the effect is no longer live, so that neat trick with rounding off the corners no longer updates the outer shape. So be sure that you're ready to apply them so that you can still take advantage of the live nature of the effect.